I'm Hazel, and this is my beginner's guide to using OBS. Open Broadcaster Studio is a free piece of software that allows you to record video on your computer, live stream to a website like Twitch, or do both at the same time. You can use it as a tool for social gaming, you can record and review your own gameplay to improve competitively, or you can record your webcam or monitor to make whatever sort of video you like. To start, download OBS Studio from obsproject.com. I've put a link in the description for you. Make sure you get OBS Studio and not OBS Classic. Studio has more features, it's cross-platform, and I found it to be more stable. Pick the right version for your operating system, install it, and load it up. Before we start recording, let's go through the settings and get some basic options nailed down. If I don't specifically talk about a setting, just copy what you see shown here to get started. If you'd like to live stream with OBS, start in the Stream tab. Select your streaming service and enter your stream key. You want to make sure that you're really private with your stream key. If someone else gets it, they can stream to your account and potentially get you banned. Under Output, we'll start with Simple Output Mode. I'll talk a bit more about bitrate in the Intermediate guide, but for now, set that to 2000. Under Recording, set your file path to the folder you want to keep your OBS footage in. Under Recording Format, set MP4 unless you know you'd like another file type. In the Audio tab, set the desktop audio device to default. If you'd like OBS to record your microphone, make sure that you have the correct one selected under Mic. In Video, set the canvas resolution to match your monitor. I use 1080p monitors, so I have that at 1920 by 1080. To record 1080 video, I'm setting my output resolution to match that. However, there's a couple reasons why you might want to bring the scaled resolution down to 1280x720 or even lower. If you have an older or less capable computer, 720 may record more smoothly. If you're live streaming to twitch.tv and you're not partnered, streaming in 720p may come across smoother for viewers with lower end connections. Or if your hard drive space is limited and you're just recording for your own use, 720p videos will have a significantly smaller file size. If you're not sure which resolution you should use, start with 1080 and then turn it down later if your video is choppy or if your computer slows down. Last, there's a hotkey section. Unless you're streaming fancy transitions and scene swaps 8 hours a day, I highly recommend that you have nothing keybound. The last thing that you want is to accidentally record random video that fills up your hard drive, or accidentally start live streaming yourself napping, or worse, behind your desk. Next, let's go over the interface and look at how to record and stream. This big block up here with the endless desktops is the preview window, which expands and shrinks as you resize the window. That shows you what your streamer video will show, and also shows it to you as you stream or record. On the left, we have scenes. You can see that I have scenes set up for my WoW livestream, recording my vlog, capturing either monitor, or recording just WoW with no camera. Here, we have the sources. That's what's actually in a given scene. You can add sources by right-clicking in the source box and selecting Add. You can put in an image, a game, a connected camera, or a display capture will show the whole monitor like I'm doing now. If I wanted to overlay an image, I go to Add, select Image. Then you can either pick a new image from your computer, or I have Cat set up here. You can do the same thing to add a game by going Add, then Game Capture, then selecting the game from a list of open software. Make sure that you have the game already running when you do this. Once you've added a game as a source, you can use it in any scene without having to do it again. When you've added in a new source, you can resize and move it by dragging the edges. To crop it, hold down Alt and then drag. Sources are stacked from top to bottom in the source list, and you can reorder them with the arrow buttons here. The mixer lets you adjust how loud the different sound sources are. Here, I can see how loud my mic is compared to my desktop sound and adjust them up, down, or mute them altogether. Now you're pretty much ready to go. Press Start Streaming to begin streaming to the website you set up earlier, or press Start Recording will start a local recording to your set folder. Press both and you'll be streaming while saving a local recording of your stream. If you forget where you're saving your recordings to, go to File and Show Recordings and it'll pull up the right folder for you. So that's enough to get you started with a basic streamer recording setup to capture video from your computer. In my next video, I'll talk about how to record with multiple audio tracks, adjusting your recording quality and file size, and how to pick a streaming bitrate and quality that's right for your internet connection. Thanks for watching! Let me know what you think, and have a wonderful, wonderful day. Bye!